chart from Bradford and the milestone from Sheffield. I'm fighting to win the second semi-final of my restaurant competition.
We want to serve every single customer like we do at home. Quick, now!
Later tonight, one of them will make it into the final and have the chance to be crowned my best restaurant.
Prashad and Milestone once again have survived my secret diners and a flying visit which really turned both their restaurants upside down. They both now face one more grueling test for a place in the final, a challenge that they've never faced before.
I've called Prashad and the Milestone to meet me in North London.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
You're probably thinking, what in the hell are we doing here this early in the morning? Standing in a pretty unimpressive room, yeah? And look at it, bare, bleak. This space now becomes your restaurants. And you're going to transform these four walls into the most amazing pop-up restaurant. Only one restaurant's going through to the final. Make sure it's you.
I'm giving each of them one floor of this empty building. They've got just 12 hours to create an exciting, vibrant pop-up restaurant that will open its doors at 7 p.m. for one night only.
Pop-up restaurants are one of the hottest tickets in the food world. They spring up in unexpected locations, cause a big storm, and then disappear overnight.
Both restaurants will have a £2,000 budget. It'll be split between the chefs...
500 is enough.
..and front of house.
You want to feel like you're in a wedding. You want to feel like you're in a party. You've got to make and create that atmosphere.
The challenge is massive.
Neither restaurant has done anything like this before. It will push them to the very limits of their creativity and their ingenuity.
Matt, players. We need to decide on players.
The decisions they make now could cost them a place in the final.
Wow, I love that table.
Oh, bollocks.
Requires assembly.
That's time.
Oh, piss it.
The chefs are heading to some of London's best markets to choose their ingredients for tonight's menu. Simon and James are looking for fantastic meat to wow their diners.
We're looking towards the thick end of the pork belly, so we want people to enjoy what they're getting. Good quality pork cheeks.
Pork liver.
Yes, pork liver and mince.
The Milestone prides itself on serving amazing classic British food.
That's all the fish cheeks we got.
After that disappointing flying visit, they'll need to prove to me that they can deliver great food plate after plate.
The people are going to see something different.
I think we're doing right there.
Coconut?
Yes. The fish is a hard noise. It's a good one.
Kaushi and Manal are in their element in the vegetable market.
For the perfect vegetarian restaurant, you need perfect vegetables. And here's the place.
Vine tomatoes,
one box over there.
Prashad serve up some of the most delicious and exciting food I've ever tasted. This challenge will show me if they have the potential to develop their restaurant and thrive outside their comfort zone.
But you know you've got 50 guests coming, yeah?
Yeah.
It doesn't look like there's enough.
Three boxes. It will be enough.
Yeah. OK, good.
Next stop for the Milestone boys, the fish wholesalers.
Right, guys, what are you thinking?
We're going for undervalued fish.
Yeah.
And just try and make them shine. So I think with pollock, line caught, it's beautiful, so we're going to cure it for a starter.
Yep.
Some skate cheeks as well.
And the grey mullet.
Grey mullets, skate cheeks, fritters. They're going off the charts big time.
I think he's a bit dubious about what we've chosen. I'm feeling that we can produce something amazing. So, and hopefully we'll come out on top.
The chefs head back to base, while their front of house teams make their final purchases.
Good then.
Dessert.
Yeah.
But have a look at
60 of those.
You see that in the glass?
Yeah.
So eight of these, yeah?
Eight of those, please.
That's the exact idea we're looking for, but not quite that. It's something that can move the light, move the room, move the atmosphere.
This is Prashad's chance to create an incredible interior a million miles away from their simple Bradford cafe.
So we're going to get some of this one then. How much do you want? 3.8 metres of the other one. Can I get 5 metres of the red?
And then what other
colour? And 3.8 metres of something else. If I get rid of the red, you can have 3.5 metres of each of these. Can I have 5 metres of both of those and I'm cancelling the red? So we get 3.5 metres of each. 7 metres of this, cancel the other red.
The chefs have just 6 hours to create culinary magic.
We've definitely got a good haul. Things get cooking it, really.
We've got everything now. We're ready to cook. There you go.
In the past, the Milestone have tried to be too clever with their dishes. Tonight, I'm looking for great British food cooked to perfection.
It's going to really show we can turn these humble ingredients into something truly spectacular on the plate.
To compete, Prasad will need to make their vegetarian menu really sing.
When you make the curry, it's hard to make it because we're making so fresh. They're getting on with it and still we are preparing. So yes, I am a little bit nervous. We don't want to panic. When you do the panic, then you always do the mistake.
These dishes include baked yam and potatoes with spiced coconut and peanut filling, vegetable pilau rice, and stuffed baby aubergines.
So you cut them in half?
Yeah.
And you stuff them with the...
with the masala.
Masala?
Yeah.
Nice. You OK?
I'm a bit panicking. I think we can make it or not on time.
Can you kick those two English guys' asses?
Definitely.
Yes. You can?
Yes.
I want both restaurants to amaze and delight my diners. I don't want carbon copies of Prasad or the milestone.
OK, you're unloading the van now, yeah?
Yeah.
We're opening just under 4 hours from now, you know that?
OK.
Yeah? Give me a feel. Prasad, what are they doing? What's the objective?
The objective is to give a wedding fair.
Who's getting married?
It's a celebration, so it's like a sharing of an environment with the food.
Wow. Good luck.
Thank you. Quite a complicated table, not planned for. Oh my goodness. It gets more complicated as we go along.
Okay, Mark. Feel and style of the room, what are you going for?
We want people to come in and be able to enjoy themselves, relax. Yep. We don't want a real formal dining experience.
Yeah. I hope
it will.
It's gonna look amazing. Okay. Guys, we're opening just under 4 hours, yeah?
Yeah.
Get going.
As soon as Gordon walked in, it dawned on me what was ahead of us. We've got to perform. We don't want to let the lads down in the kitchen. They're going to do their side. We need to make sure we do our side. So there's a lot of pressure on us.
With the amount of time we've got, fingers crossed, we will literally just be ready.
So really, we've just got to get as much prep done now. So it's ready for service.
Get it all done. Just don't stop. As soon as you stop, we'll lose. If we don't stop, we won't.
Bobby has been bold with his plans for the space. I hope he has time to put it off.
Under pressure. Still not getting any further forward with these tables.
Unless... I know we're pushed for time.
Yeah.
Yeah, but just run downstairs, pop your head downstairs very quickly.
All right, looking fantastic.
Okay. They're looking in a pretty good shape, aren't they?
They are.
And this is looking like a campsite.
The biggest mistake we've made is we didn't go for ready-made tables.
Right now, we're sort of on our second table.
Yeah.
Getting put together. We're opening in just under 3 hours from now, and we've got a lot to do. Yeah?
Yeah.
What are they?
Cutlery.
Jesus, where'd you go, a fucking camp shop?
we're trying to go with the look and the feel of the tables and match everything with the whites and the blacks.
Jesus. Wow. Don't put them too close to the candle, they'll melt.
OK, thank you. He's fucking not impressed, is he? Gordon. We're not looking very good right now. We've got lots to do. We've made some mistakes in our decisions. Not good, not happy right now. A lot of pressure, not really sure what I'm going to do.
Bobby's in a mess, and it looks dreadful. Pretty crap, knife and forks, and dreadful tables, like they've been hanging around outside a pub.
I feel absolutely deflated right now, but we'll get it done. Can't see the end in sight, so quite nervous. Just need 2 hours. 2 hours is a long time. We didn't come all this way to lose because we couldn't build tables.
Downstairs, the milestone are much happier with their tables, but they haven't paid any attention to the rest of their space.
The tables look great.
Yeah.
Yeah? The restaurant looks shit. There's no thought process with the tarting up four walls. I'm interested in a stunning restaurant, yeah?
Yeah.
That's what I would like to see, yeah? But have you got any fabrics?
No.
Cushions or...
not, no.
Ornate pieces of furniture to liven up?
No. This is it.
The idea of a pop-up restaurant, yeah? It's not just the location, but it's a shown-off aspect. Do you know what I mean? You rear your own pigs, you make your own bread and... come in the dining room, it's like, I know what you guys are like when you use your imagination. So I give you the flexibility to go and do something out the box. Okay. What a shame.
Fucking hell.
It's a one night only. £2,000 to create something exciting and magical and the wow factor. Milestone are going for something simplistic. They've played it safe, but that may not get you into the final.
There's no lack of ambition in the kitchen, however. Simon and James are serving slariac and skate scampi with their silver mullet and braised oxtail accompanied by English squash and wild mushrooms.
That's your oxtail.
Yeah.
So you should be happy, that's cooked in time.
Yeah.
That tastes delicious, really nice.
It's not over 10 days, Josh.
That's lovely.
If they pull this food off, it will be amazing.
What's this one here? Peas in there?
It's mutter paneer. Mm-hmm. Peas and paneer.
Mm-hmm. That's delicious. That's delicious.
Things are taking shape. Two tables are done. Time is on our hands. It's actually looking quite nice. We could do this.
Kaushi and Manal seem oblivious to what's happening upstairs.
What do you think of this? What? What do you think of that?
Too cheap.
It's too what? Cheap. Yeah, it's nasty. Huh?
Tables are coming together. The forks and knives are ridiculous. The rest of the table looks good.
You got all the cutlery on the table for both courses?
No. We haven't unwrapped it yet.
Okay, well, do you care, Bobby?
I care a lot, Bobby.
You do? I'm worried. Shit cutlery, plain Jane dining room, and I know you can do better. I'm really sorry, because I've seen you perform. And today's not one of those days.
We didn't sit back and think about this properly in terms of the ambience, in terms of what we wanted to create. And that's showing now. The cracks are showing.
With very little time left before Prashad open their doors, Kaushi goes upstairs to the dining room.
We have made some errors, you know, but we can't constantly focus on them. We can't change those errors right now.
It's OK. Just get your name, OK?
Yeah?
Yeah. I'm sure you will do it.
Trying to step away back now from the nervousness and go, look, this is it. It's perfectly on the line. If it shit or bust. If it goes bad, we're back to Sheffield. We've done the best we can, but we're here to win it.
Listen to me, yeah? Every part of what we do is with our heart. We're a 22-seat restaurant working our guts off. If we're not good enough, we're not good enough. We'll still give it our best shot.
We're opening in just under 5 minutes from now, and this is it. Everything they've worked for all day depends on this service, and I've never had an evening that's been so dependent on an amazing performance in the kitchen, because both restaurants have been let down by the front of house, and it's up to the kitchen now to pull it back.
Next, my two semi-finalists feel the heat in their pop-up restaurants, but which one will have the edge and win a place in the upcoming final?
Quick, now!
You can get chippy with me, so she can't promise the table.
No.